This is Sincere TV.
From Fisherman's Walk in historic Monterey, let's see who's under the bathroom mat.
When I was young,
it's Karen Carpenter, one of the greatest singers of all time. Top 10? Yeah. Born in 1950 in New Haven, Connecticut, the Carpenters family moved to Downey, California to get away from the cold. As a boy, Richard was fascinated by Les Paul's early multi-track recording techniques.
Somewhere there's music, I'll paint the tune. Somewhere there's heaven, how high the moon.
Now I'll add a tenor part to that.
Somewhere there's music, I'll paint the tune. Somewhere there's heaven, how high the moon.
Somewhere there's music.
Karen was a true alto with those deep, rich notes.
After long enough of being alone, everyone must face their share of loneliness.
Truly great singers have a way of shaping sounds to make them sound really special. Karen has this in spades.
That tomorrow will be just the same for you and me. All I need will be mine if you are here.
John Lennon went up to Karen in a Los Angeles restaurant and said, I've got to tell you, love, you've got a fabulous voice.
And all is really godly blue, Jago.
She has absolute perfect timing. She's a drummer after all. In 1975, she was voted best rock drummer in a Playboy readers poll, beating out Led Zeppelin's John Bonham. After being in a band straight out of high school and getting nowhere, Richard and Karen decided to go it alone as the Carpenters. They were signed to A&M Records and had a minor hit with the Lennon McCartney song, Ticket to Ride. A&M label boss Herb Albert asked his songwriting team of Burt Bacharach and Hal David for a song. They gave him Close to You.
Why do birds suddenly appear?
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Burt Bacharach.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love.
Close to you.
With Karen on lead and backing vocals, Richard on keyboards and backing vocals, Hal Blaine, not Karen, from the so-called Wrecking Crew on drums, and with the influence from their California neighbors, the Beach Boys, some pretty rich harmonies. Close to You went to number one in the US and the UK. I'm standing in front of the Tree of Sincerity in Santa Cruz, California, where in 1974, Karen came to me and asked me to help her with her harmonies.
And when the evening comes, we smile.
We've Only Just Begun was another massive US hit, reaching number two on the charts. It showcases Richard's excellent and unique production skills. The producer on the label was Jack Dougherty, but Richard said he didn't do anything, it was all him. A string of hits followed. Rainy Days and Mondays.
Rainy Days and Mondays always get me down.
Karen was reluctant to get out from behind the drums when they performed live, but eventually she did. Superstar, perhaps one of her finest vocal performances. And that's a pretty high bar.
Long ago, and oh so far away,
I'll say goodbye to love.
Goodbye to Love was written by Richard Carpenter and John Bettis and included a fuzzy rock guitar solo by Tony Peluso. Tony asked Richard what he wanted him to do, and Richard said, just go for it. It's the first big guitar solo in a pop ballad. And there are two solos, including a full 68 seconds on the run out. Richard said it generated hate mail from their fans. Yesterday Once More, Top of the World, and Only Yesterday were also top 10 hits written by Richard and John Bettis. Their final top 10 hit, Kinda Hush, in 1976, had been a hit for Herman's Hermits in the UK and was written by one of my favorite songwriters of the time, Jeff Stevens. Eventually, touring took its toll, 180 days a year. Richard started taking Quaaludes and soon became dependent, and Karen started losing weight. Her health deteriorated and she developed anorexia. Karen married real estate developer Tom Burris in 1980. Karen desperately wanted children, but he had undergone a vasectomy and hadn't told her, and he refused to reverse the procedure. Their marriage did not survive this disagreement, and it ended after 14 months. For her entire life, Karen had felt desperately unloved by her mother Agnes, who favored Richard. As a result, she suffered from low self-esteem, which led to the mental illness from which she never recovered. The Carpenters were one of the biggest selling American musical acts of all time. Between 1970 and 1984, they had 17 top 20 hits, 10 gold singles, 9 gold albums, 1 multi-platinum album, and 3 Grammys. And in total, they sold more than 100 million records. Thanks for watching. You've been Under the Bathroom Mat on Sincere TV with me, Tim Sincere.